June 28, 1491. I was a lucky child because only half of my siblings survived infancy. By age two, I was already the Duke of York and Warden of the Scottish Marches. I had a first-rate education, and even as a child, I was fluent in Latin and French. Because I was not expected to become king, I led a relatively normal childhood. The first fact that is known about me is that I married Catherine of Aragon when I was age 17, after my cousin died. It was my father's dying wish that we should be married, so after we were married, we became king and queen. Our relationship was going well until 2 days after the marriage, when I had to arrest and execute a few of my ministers for being accused of treason. Our relationship went downhill after that because Catherine of Aragon could not have any male children. I wanted to divorce her, but the Pope said no. How dare the Pope just talk back to me like this? So I broke with the church and divorced her anyway. In 1512, I declared war on our ally France, and I invaded in 1513. In that same year, I secretly married Anne Boleyn. I was discontented with her as well, after the only child she had was also a girl. So I had her arrested and beheaded on trumped-up charges of treason.
Oh, my goodness. Evil man.
After her, I married Jane Seymour, who was Anne's lady-in-waiting. As they say, the third time is the charm, so in 1537, I finally had a male child, Edward I. Unfortunately, Jane Seymour died in childbirth. But since I was the king, I could marry anyone I wanted, so I married Anne of Cleves. This marriage was arranged by Thomas Cromwell to establish ties to Germany. This marriage was a disaster, and I divorced her. Obviously, this disaster was not my fault, and I had to have someone to blame for it. So I blamed Thomas Cromwell, and he was beheaded the next day.
Oh my gosh!
My next marriage was to Catherine Parr. This was a slight mismatch, too. Obviously not my fault, but it was a slight mismatch, because by this time I was 49 and she was only 16. But I must have had something going for me, probably my strapping body. This marriage was pleasing, but after it became known that she had many affairs with my courtiers, I was forced to behead her in 1542. My sixth marriage was to Catherine Parr. She acted like a nurse to me, because by this time I was getting quite old and my health was failing. It was a harmonious marriage, but unfortunately it took me a little too long to find such a good match, and I died the next year. At the ripe old age of 55. I was succeeded by my son, and buried next to Jane Seymour. I was succeeded by my son, Edward I, but obviously he was not as immensely great of a figure as I was.